is a Texas-sized welcome for their hometown guys. They're fired up and ready to go as they get set to match up with the Seattle Seahawks. Carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. They go play action with Wilson. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And the defense loses him. It's complete. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle.
Well, you normally talk about the mobility and the accuracy first, but the arm strength, that's what can turn Russ into danger Russ.
Extra point up and through by Myers. And that makes the score 7-0. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. On the return, Tremont Smith.
And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line.
Watson will bring up the Texans here, first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. Now a play fake, and it's Watson.
He's got his man. It's the tight end, Brevin Jordan.
And he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there. A gain of 6 there on first. We'll see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up the touchdown on the opening drive.
And based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. In fact, the discussion that we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so offense has to be ready each and every time to either equal or try and get us ahead and try and keep us ahead. This is their chance to respond to that first touchdown given up.
for the weekend. I'ma go with it for the weekend. Sports mode, cause I be speeding. No safety, I'm bleeding. I can never fumble like defense.
To email the venues and ask them if I could be opening an act for the rappers that's passing through town. I used to be the one kids in my city was laughing about. I used to envision everything happening now. I used to ride the bus and listen to Kendrick Lamar. He just liked a video that I made back when I started to study his bars. I'd like to think that he probably related to someone that's come so far. To someone that wanted it badly, then when it got it and turned to a star. Overly dedicated, a title that resonated. I want to be recognized, I want to be decorated. Truthfully, back then I couldn't imagine a life where I never made it. Go ahead and let them hate it.
I ain't never had no money.
pleased to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. The scene from a few moments ago, this crowd enthusiastically cheering on their Texans as they emerge from the locker room. And we're just about ready for football as the Texans get set to match up with the Seattle Seahawks. Three quarters of the NFL season are complete. What works in our final month? We're underway in week 14. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. First down, it's Watson. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Here's second and 7 now from the 28. From the gun, here's Watson. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked up by the linebacker, Bobby Wagner. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops. So far this season, this defense has had their issues against the pass, so that's a great sign for them to get the early pick.
Yeah, confidence builder for them and an absolute shock for the quarterback because he went into it. He saw the numbers we saw. He watched them on tape. I think he came into this one thinking this is going to be a big day, and it very well could be. But early in this one, advantage defense.
After the interception, here's Wilson. Flushed out right. That's to the tight end, Colby Parkinson. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. First down, Seattle, 16 yards the gain there. This is the Oklahoma State alum, Chris Carson. And he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
He'll buy some time right.
Good, sure hands there from a guy not accustomed to catching a whole lot of passes. But how about the way he was able to pull that one in and pick up good yardage?
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Wilson now off the bootleg. End zone caught. Touchdown, Seattle. Gerald Everett, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Seahawks have taken a first quarter lead.
As a general rule, quarterbacks don't want to lock in on a receiver before the ball is snapped. But in this case, based on the matchup he thought he was going to get, it was favorable for his tight end. He locked in on him early and found him for a touchdown.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win.
What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
23 yards on the play. So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Off of play action, it's Watson. He's letting it fly for Cooks. And this is caught. Touchdown, Houston. Brandon Cooks, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Texans are an extra point away from tying this football game. But hard to believe that arm strength was a knock on Deshaun Watson coming out of Clemson, but he showed what he's got there. Kaimi Fairbairn on for the extra point. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense.
And they are back down to 500 following the loss last week. Consistency has been a real issue for them so far.
Brandon, you almost don't know what team is going to show up every week. I mean, there's no consistency with this ball club at all, and if we feel that way, I know it frustrates the coaching staff, and it also has to frustrate the key leaders in the locker room. They got to figure out how to get coordinated.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. The play fake. Here's Wilson. That's into the hands of his tight end, Will Dissly. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down. They run the counter. It's Carson, and he'll just plow right into a host of tacklers. Nothing there at all, and it'll be second and 10. They'll try the left side. Carson, and he goes across midfield and down into Houston territory.
Well, sometimes it's hard to take your eyes off this guy at the linebacker position. He can really cover some ground, and he did there to make that play.
And sometimes all of your best laid plans of play design, your X's and O's, they can't always account for individual effort defensively. And this was one of those times. Just a terrific play to hustle over there and get the running back to the ground.
And his top speed, as computed by Next Gen Stats, not bad. He was pushing 20 miles an hour.
Looking for Lockett, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Terrence Mitchell, and they will take over at the 29-yard line.
And this, Charles, definitely not what they were wanting to see. Remember, he threw three interceptions in the loss last week, and now he gives the ball away again here in the very first quarter.
And you have to think that this was drilled into him all week, too, by his teammates, by his coaching staff. They've told him all week long, we've got to protect the football. They probably crossed that fine line with giving him the right advice and saying it too much, and it turned out that it got into his head a little bit.
Watson will bring up the Texans here, first and 10, just shy of the 30. After the interception, here's Watson. Got this into the hands of the tight end, Jordan. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play.
Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Second down at 5. Faking the give. Now Watson. Open man is Jordan, the tight end. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw it, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to 1.
On first down, Watson. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And oh, he almost had his second pick of the game. Probably should have. Yeah, he's frustrated as it falls incomplete.
I'm looking at this one with my defensive eyeglasses on because you remember the old days when a tight end saw a linebacker covering him and thought he had a mismatch? But the way they can run nowadays, not necessarily so. They gave it a shot downfield. That one incomplete.
And getting our first update now from Nashville. You saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. Remember to keep an eye on the ticker, of course, at the bottom of your screen for updates on that game and others around the NFL. Watson's throw going to be taken in by Johnson. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as a tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks 39. That good for 21 yards on the catch and run. So from Seahawk territory now, it's first and 10 at the 39-yard line. Watson, off play action. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And that is caught. Touchdown, Texans. Two first quarter touchdown passes now for Deshaun Watson. And the Texans have taken the lead. Precision, precision, precision. That's the definition of it right there. Great pass, great catch for the score.
Yeah, people talk about arm strength all the time. Well, if you're not precise and you're not accurate, the arm strength really doesn't matter. We saw a little bit of everything with that throw.
Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. Taken in at the 3. And he won't quite make it to the 25. Into the line here to begin their next drive. The Seahawks offense. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right?
And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down.
Well, that's tough, Charles. First play of the drive, you're hoping to stay ahead of schedule. You take that huge sack, and now you're facing second and a mile.
And the entire time, you were probably thinking the same thing I was. Either get rid of the ball, safely, of course, or go down. The yardage he gave up on that play, that's going to be tough for them to make up.
That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. Another try after the first down sack. Wilson flush to his right. Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. And the Texans scoop it. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line.
I know that taking care of the football is something that's drummed into every guy who plays this position, no matter what, whether it's running it in the pocket, out of the pocket. But it's almost surprising to me that there aren't more fumbles by that position because of the way that they get attacked on each and every play.
Yeah, well, he had the fumble last week. Now, here's 2 weeks in a row with a fumble loss.
Concentration has got to be there, and he's got to understand how much time he has to take care of a play. And maybe his clock is off just a little bit.
And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Through one quarter, 14-7, our score. Now a first and 10 at the 11. That's caught out wide by Cooks. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
Second and 7.
You can't block me. You can't block me.
A shotgun snap for Watson. And a quick throw here, that's complete. Touchdown, Texans! Deshaun Watson with his third touchdown pass of this first half. And the Texans push further out in front.
And that's exactly what you're supposed to do with good field position. You make the other side pay when you don't have far to go for the score.
Fairbairn good with the extra point. And it's now 21-7. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions, but some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, punt the ball away, get yourself set to play defense, but when you turn it over, it changes momentum, and when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
11 yards there and a first down for Seattle. From the shotgun, Wilson. It's brought incomplete. It's John Brown. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. Looking to throw again on second down. Wilson steps away to his left. Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. And the Texans scoop it. Taking it right down Broadway. And they will bring this one back. A fumble return for a Texans touchdown. This first half has been a nightmare for that offense. Defense just dominating them.
And when you're picking up the ball, picking up their mistakes, and taking it the other way and putting it in the end zone, that's a defense's dream. They're having that type of a game.
Everything that can go wrong has gone wrong for this offensive unit. Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns in 21. And you can bet they're preaching 2 hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And they weren't on the sidelines for long, but I'll tell you what, I'm glad you and I weren't down there. We could hear them, the coaches. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Malik Collins. What an effort from him on that play. Big tackle for a loss of 11. Well, they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. Another try after the first down sack. Wilson going for Metcalf on the deep ball. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Picked off at the 36. And a great return here gets this one all the way down to the 26-yard line. They set themselves behind the chains, tried to get it all back in one play, and it backfired.
Didn't feel like a pitcher working his way into a 3-0 count, right? You're behind. What do your coaches always tell you? Get it back one pitch at a time. In this case, they tried to get it back right away, and it didn't work out.
Now a first down throw, Watson. He finds his man complete. It's Jordan. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down. Out of the gun, Watson. And he'll get this underneath to David Johnson. 5 yards on the pickup, and it'll be second down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
To throw again on second down, Watson. Open man is Cooks. He's got it. Touchdown, Texans. Deshaun Watson, 4 touchdown passes now in the ball game, and the Texans are able to widen their lead here in this first half. Now he's having a nice little first half here, partner.
It's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, 2 touchdowns already here through the second quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
So after the touchdown, here's Fairbair now to kick it away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. They run it with Carson. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it. When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot, he had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done, because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Pressure comes, and Wilson's going to go down.
Are you seeing what I'm seeing? That's 3 sacks now. And this team came into the game in the bottom 5 in the league in sacks.
Yeah, this
What's
is
going
not,
on?
It's not been their bread and butter. I don't know. Is a blind squirrel finding a nut, or is this something they can build on?
Well, they found some momentum. They found a crack in that offensive line, and they're putting it to good use.
Wilson of the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's 3rd and long here. They go play action now. Wilson. Out left, he's got it to Everett. And he can only manage to take the football to the 40, and that is well shy of the first down marker. They get 12 yards back, but it still leads to a 4th and long. And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. On 4th down, ready to punt, Michael Dixon. He gets this away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And this will depend on the spot as it sails out of bounds. And they'll say it sailed out at the 10-yard line.
Let's go old school there. That's absolutely a great coffin corner punt. Someone's put some time in working on that, hasn't it?
Seems like every year these guys get better and better. It's amazing how they can command that football through the air.
Yeah, they used to actually practice with hula hoops where they place them and try and put them there. Now a lot of guys use barrels on the sidelines to try and put the football in one.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. Now a pass hauled in downfield. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. 25 yards that time.
And they were backed up to start the drive, but not anymore. Now that's the play call that the offensive coordinator had in his head. You saw the end result. He wanted to go ahead and push the ball downfield, and that's what they did. And they wound up with good yardage there to get things rolling.
And he'll get this up to about the 40. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
And that was a pleasing run from Philip Lindsay coming over from the Denver Broncos to join now a crowded backfield with the Houston Texans. But why is it so crowded? Because they finished 31st in the league last year in rushing, and they're trying to find anyone who can lead them and get that running game moving in Houston.
And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line, tackled there. That's good for a Texan first down, a 12-yard pickup.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this a little bit of math here. 4 plays, 3 first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success.
On 1st and 10, it's Lindsay. And he'll work this forward for about 3. It's 2nd down. So we've come to halftime after a very one-sided beginning to this one. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. The Seahawks trailing, but they will have possession first here as we resume action in the 3rd quarter. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense.
And they have a mountainous deficit looming in front of them. It was really, Charles, a disaster of a first half, so where do they go from here?
Well, first thing they have to remember is that what's done is done.
And Wilson's going to be intercepted a 3rd time. Picked up by Justin Reed. And they will score a pick 6 for the Texans TD. So this defense doubling its pleasure there. Remember, they had the fumble return for a score earlier in the game. And now this time, an interception return for another score. Fairbairn now to add the extra point. And the lead grows even larger here in the 3rd quarter. So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is just what you said. You've gone over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point. On 2nd down, it's Carson. Only able to get it to his own 20 after breaking through the contact. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on 1st down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on 2nd.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
Now Wilson. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Picked up by Justin Reed. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. Charles, whatever's going on between his ears right now, it's just not completely calculated correctly. 7 picks between last week and this week after that one.
And they always say the most important part of a player is those 6 inches between the ears. But right now, it's all those interceptions that are going on. So whoever his trusted confidant is on the sidelines, I don't know if it's the offense coordinator, the quarterback's coach, maybe the backup quarterback, that's who he needs to get with now and get himself calm.
44 yards rushing for him now, and he's only carried the ball 4 times. So 1st and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second-half blowout material. Now a carry for Lindsey, and he's eaten up at the line of scrimmage. Might have gotten a yard down to the 16.
It went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a 2nd back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
Here's 2nd and 9. Now Watson. Throw complete right side to Cooks. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's 3rd down.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran it a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line, but once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
On 3rd down, Johnson. And he won't be close to a 1st down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a 4th down. Watson going to stay out there as they'll go for it on 4th. And now the Seahawks are going to take a timeout here on defense. It's just their 1st, so 2 remaining as they burn 1 here in this 3rd quarter. So they're going to come to the line here, and it appears trying to go for it on 4th. They're going with Lindsey, and he won't get there. They stop him a few yards short of the line to gain. The Texans tried it, but they come up empty here on 4th. And the Seahawks are going to take over the football. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They've got to dig down deep. I mean, they need something right now, really anything to cling on to. This offense has struggled.
Partner, join me in a walk to their locker room at the half, okay? Because I think what we would have seen is an offensive coordinator and his assistant coaches getting together with all their positions, then coming together as a group, going over adjustments, and then the head coach coming in and just screaming, wake up. Yeah. Let's get moving, guys.
I'm kind of glad we weren't in there at halftime, actually.
I mean, you think you might have turned it on us, too?
Yeah, but right now, whatever was said hasn't been working. 2nd and 10. Play action. Now Wilson. Sliding out of the pocket. Throw right side is into the hands of his tight end, Everett. Maybe a frustration penalty there because he's picked them apart.
They've tried their best to get to him and haven't done it successfully. A penalty as a result of that hit there.
So now a fresh set of downs. 1st and 10 after roughing the passer. Play action. It's Wilson. Pressure comes and Wilson's going to go down. Zach Cunningham rolling in to get the sack. Back quite a ways here, facing 2nd and 19. Another try after the first down sack. Wilson rolling to his right, and he'll just get rid of it.
I think you can easily follow the thinking there. The pressure on the last play, it got to him, so they decided, let's get him out of there, bootleg him out to the right. Unable to complete the pass downfield, but the thought process, spot on.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. There's Wilson to throw. He's got his man. That's Everett, the tight end. And he takes it all the way down to the 44-yard line. A huge gain of 40 yards on the third down conversion. From the gun, it's Wilson. And he's going to go down. The Texans come at him and able to bring him to the ground. Whitney Merciless in there to get him. And on the season now, that is 9 sacks for him. So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. Another try after the first down sack. Wilson. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off at the 45. And they will score a pick six for the Texans TD. This D wanted to put it away before we even get to the fourth quarter, widening that margin a bit further.
And while they won't just empty the bench just yet, if you're a backup, start loosening up. I think you'll get a chance to play before this one is over now with that type of a cushion.
Fairbairn good with the extra point. And the lead will swell by one more. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game, and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
And this will be a Seahawks first down as the tackle made at about the 38.
First downs have not come easy, and neither have runs like this throughout this game.
Absolutely not. He finally felt like, whoa, a sigh of relief. We got something going in the running game. Penny, a first down carry. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Now they'll throw it with Wilson. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. A game there of 30 big ones. On first and 10, it's Wilson. And he's going to go down here as sack. They push him back to the 34. Whitney Merciless has now recorded 10 sacks on the season. To at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. Another try after the first down sack. Wilson, and pressure coming, and they got him once again.
We've been around this league for a while, and many coaches never pull their starting quarterback, almost no matter the situation. In this case, though, I think he's got to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, and with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury. Wilson of the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's third and long here. Wilson. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Brown. It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. That's on target, but it's no good. He had it online, but it came up just shy of the crossbar. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. We find ourselves here in the midst of a one-sided affair. A lot of fill time down the stretch, Mr. Davis.
So we could talk about food, because that is something that you and I both enjoy.
We share that.
We enjoy our time at the table. So maybe the best steakhouses in the city, but in all seriousness, the performances that we've seen this year, we've seen a bunch of great ones, and it's going to be hard to parse who's going to win the MVP.
Yeah, it really is.
Is it going to be a runner? Is it going to be a thrower? Can a defender finally win it this season? Those are the things that we could probably discuss.
And collectively, this is about as dominant of a performance as you could have hoped for on both sides of the football.
Might have to put it number one for what we've seen this season.
Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. Throwing on third down, Watson. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. He's got a man, complete. And he is down deep into Seattle territory. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Even with a big lead here in the fourth, it still bombs away. And frankly, it's working. Why should they stop? Go ahead and keep firing away and gaining those yards.
Coming up on the final 2.5 minutes. And boy, has it been fun to watch this offense operate. Quite the display, and now they look to polish it off. And a hard-earned yard there as he ran through one would-be tackler. It's second down. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
Here's second and goal, operating from the 8-yard line. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Texans football as we welcome you back. Nothing on first down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, second and goal. They'll get this halfway home from the 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
Third and goal as they look to pour some more salt in the wound. They'll try to run with Lindsay. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1-yard line. Defense keeps him out of the end zone there. Now, will they go for it? And if so, can they do it one more time?
Yeah, I just don't know if it's worth it going for it, because what we've seen from the defense so far, every gap is taken care of. Everyone is sound in their coverage. No one is breaking free. And those ball carriers are getting tagged. If I were them, I'd think very hard about just taking 3 points and taking their dignity and moving on.
And the ball's at the 2, spotted at the 2, so a pretty good chunk to go. An option run with Ingram, and he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. This defense held out as long as they could, but ultimately the running game wears them down from the 1-yard line.
And that gets set up throughout the entire drive, doesn't it? And when you put those big bodies and determination into that carry, the end result, touchdown.
On for the PAT, Kaimi Fairbairn. Now this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. after the touchdown. Here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense.
They are just obviously getting shellacked here on this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest.
Don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Yeah, use that as ammo
exactly.
Going forward.
Exactly. Take a great look at that scoreboard. Realize how poorly everything went for us today. Coaching, playing, the whole deal. And never forget it, because
you're not going to want that feeling
again. No, you don't want that feeling again. And who knows? You may meet up with this team again.
The throw down the field, caught by his running back. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They get 17 on that one. Move the chains. First down, Seahawks. Being chased out left. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And he drops it incomplete, and their struggles continue here.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield.
Throwing is Wilson. He's going to let it fly. And unable to connect, incomplete. Now give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
They'll break the huddle here and go for it. This is fourth down. Here we go. It's Wilson on fourth down. That's to his running back, complete. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. Now the Seahawks forced to use their third and final timeout, as the clock will stop with an even 20 seconds left to go. Wilson after the play fake to Carson. And that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now.
That was well played, but that was also an example of a corner who understands his coverage, realized he had support behind him, and could be a little more aggressive in the shorter zone, and did exactly that, knocking that pass away.
To throw on second and 10. Wilson, oh, he's going to let this go for the end zone. And this is caught. Well, they get one back, picking up the late touchdown here, but still down big.
Well, he's been doing this for a lot of years, with the arm strength still there, and he showed it off on that one.
Now Myers for the extra point. And they make the score a little bit more respectable here in our final quarter of play. So despite the huge deficit, they're going to keep fighting. Here comes the onside kick. And the effort snuffed out. The Texans' hands team recovers. Now they're down big here in the fourth. They had to try the onside kick. Can't fault them for the effort, at least.
No, you can't at all. And if nothing else, now you've put something that you're trying to practice, right, that you've worked on into a game situation, and now you can go back and dissect it. So if you need it again sometime, maybe you'll find a better way to do it. But, yeah, this game's pretty much done for them.
Down to an Eagles Watson, and that should just about do it for this ball game. But Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all.
Bet get this double double. Make sure you're bubble in this game because I love the trouble. So watch your tone if you don't want to rumble. You pop, pop, like my, did you forget we know you're not with any inch of the real, real. So stop it. I ain't knocking your little hustle, but watch it. I would hate to hear that.